Hello, Steve Roach here, Serum Culture, with another webinar for you. This is the Serum Culture Email Templates module. E-templates, why do we need them? A couple of use cases here for you. Users need a way to send a single email template, which you can't do, and small batches, which you can do, but it's a little awkward. And then the second use case is I need a way to merge PDFs as attachments, such as sending out a list of invoices and have an actual merged invoice PDF go out. Or in financial services, you might have a client statement being merged as a PDF. This bridges the gap between Microsoft Word templates. Letter Express is what Pivotal's technology is, and Pivotal's e-marketing module, which is very robust but a little hard to use for the lay user. E-marketing is definitely a great tool for large email campaigns that require tracking, but as I mentioned, it's really designed for a marketer person and not for the end user. The templates is easier and more robust than Letter Express and has more features that we need. Some of the benefits here, I just call your attention to the two bolded items, because these, as we understand it, are very distinct and big differentiators. No other CRM that we know of has this capability, especially the third line item there. General rules of all Serum Culture products are no coding. They work for any custom table generically without any coding. They just install and they work. Just a little demo for us here. We're going to start with an email template that's probably the most complex one, which is an invoice or an order. We're going to use that one because we can demonstrate all of the functionality right from this particular one. So let's just take a look at the design of an actual e-template itself. So we have the basic information here, the table that it's hooked to. That's going to mean that when you email it or when you choose to use this template, you're going to have a list of orders. We have our merge tags, which we'll talk about in a moment. Because we're coming from an order and not a contact, we have to figure out how we're going to actually email that to a person. And so we resolve that to the bill to contact ID instead of the ship to. Either one of those would have worked. Then this is very unique to the e-templates and solves a huge problem, which is the ability to run this report, a crystal report, merge it, and then attach it as a PDF. And that's very novel. The ability to merge into the subject, that Letter Express doesn't have that capability. Of course, we have a rich HTML editor here that supports embedded images and so forth. Now let's just take a look at the tags, as you can see here. So we can have any field that's on the table or above the table or below, as in secondary data. So let's just do a simple one first, where we're going to navigate up into the bill-to company to go get its zip code. And we can come down here, eventually get its zip code. There it is. And that'll go right in there. Then sometimes you might also want to merge information about the current user, such as a generic template that has a signature that everybody can use. So I might want to go get some additional information about that and get information from the current user. So that means any user who runs this template, this information is going to be merged for them. So that's right out of the Letter Express features. So Letter Express obviously has that feature. And then here's a feature that Letter Express does not have, and very novel to Pivotal. I don't know of any other CRMs that have this capability, which is the capability to merge secondary data generically. So what we're going to do here is, when we say secondary data, we mean the data such as the many line items of an invoice. And the way we solve this problem is we'll still have some help from the toolkit person to define a search result list for us that has the column, order, and fields that you want to display. And then that exposes itself here via security. And then you can just double click on it and then format it accordingly. Last thing to note is we do support static attachments as well, just regular old PDFs. So if you were going to send a single email, the ones that have a brochure or something like this, you can do that. Now let's just take a look at some use cases. So what we're going to do is we're going to just take a list of companies here, and we'll right-click to choose our hypernavigation. If we had some templates, we must have some for companies, but I'm just going to get a list of contacts first to start with. And we're going to send some email, just to keep this fast, we're going to send some email to just a few people. And what we do is from a search result list or wherever, we can say send an email template like so. And that's going to bring up our list. And if I have, these are contact-based templates. So just to show some variety of templates we have here. And of course, it's going to be merging in all of the different information. That's got a graphic on it. Now, I'm going to just do my order to keep this webinar fairly short. And we'll just let's see if we've got any order data for any of these people. So what we're going to do here is we'll hyper-navigate to, well, we'll go back to the primary company. And I know we've got some orders for these companies, and now we'll navigate back down to their orders. Okay, so we've got some order data. Like so, and we're going to batch merge those orders. And we know that that template that we're going to use was the orders with secondary, and it also had a report as an attachment. So there's our first order with some line item data merged in, our second order, and our third order. And if we just send all, we can go look at the mail. Now this just confirms that the email does go out through your sent mail, through your Outlook, so you wouldn't want to use this for thousands of emails. You can see here that it did the attachment as a merged attachment. Here's the line items for that particular one. And then last thing we'll look at is a contact. And we can see that the email itself was linked to the contact. We can see Serum Culture's preview window here as well that supports HTML and so forth. And I guess the last thing to note is we can see that we can send an email template as a onesie from a single record, which is kind of nice if you are sending a brochure or a training invite, you know, whatever it is that you want to send as a one-off. And that will, of course, open up Outlook as a single email, like so. I won't save that. And the last thing to note is that just like all Serum Culture context menu items, if you are on any place where there is a list of items, such as here, so in Out-of-Box Pivotal, you would not be able to use a Letter Express for that situation because it's in a grid. And so what we could do here is we could right-click, and we can choose Send Email Template, and we get the same basic functionality. So that concludes our webinar for today. If you have any questions, please feel free to give us a call at 303-875-7163 or visit serumculture.com. Thanks.